This is Hugh back to the studio. In its relations with China, the United States has resorted to unprecedented tactics. On July 21st, the U.S. asked China to close Houston Consulate for some reasons. The spokesperson of the U.S. State Department said that it was to protect American intellectual property. CNN speculated that it was related to the quarantine policy towards U.S. diplomats in China, while White House advisor Comey said it is because Trump is unhappy with China's response to the epidemic. In short, no one can tell. The information chaos just shows Washington's intentions. If you are out to condemn somebody, you can always trump up a charge. Wu Xinbo, executive dean of Institute of International Studies, Fudan University, pointed out that this move by the United States violated basic diplomatic rules. Its China policy has become hysterical. The coming election drives the Hawks into countdown madness. It is expected that China-U.S. relations will be in a critical severe moment until the end of the year. Washington is meddling, and the American people are watching. To deal with a fall-line Washington, Beijing will surely impose tit-for-tat measures. This is the best way to help the sick America overcome insanity. In this hostile political climate, however, news came out that Mark Esper, the U.S. Secretary of Defense, plans to visit China before the end of the year. Esper, who graduated from West Point Military Academy and has just marked a year in office, released a signal even more certain. He hopes to enhance cooperation on areas of common interest, establish a system necessary for crisis communications. The nuance of statement made by the Pentagon is clearly different from the overheated anti-China tactics provided by the White House. At this point, we do not overinterpret the Pentagon's incentive. However, it would be a welcome move to hit the brakes on the rapid deterioration of China-U.S. relations. This is Stu, until next time.